time. I'm so glad you're joining me tonight. That's right, it's Monday night. It's February 1st, first of the month, and we woke up to snow here in New York. I don't know where you are, but here we have a lot of snow, and it's not supposed to stop till tomorrow morning. So we're going to be out there shoveling more, and once you shovel, the plows come down, and you have to shovel more. It's just so exciting, but you know, it's cardio. You get it in, right? So listen, I'm going to talk about my weekend really, really quick because I didn't do much. For me, as some of you know, and I want to thank you for all your prayers, I am getting over COVID. I now have this residual cough because I have COVID lungs, but thank God I'm doing much, much better. So every day is a little better for me. And you know what? I have to relax. Doctor's orders. You have to relax, drink a lot of fluids. And I took advantage of that. And it was a Tom Hanks weekend. I love Tom Hanks. I've loved him since Bosom Buddies. So I watched this weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I watched Philadelphia, which, you know, I needed my box of tissues for that one. And then I watched Sleepless in Seattle. And then Big, that I can watch over and over again. And it just makes me laugh all the time. So thank you, Tom Hanks, for a wonderful weekend for me. Today's my grandfather's birthday. May he rest in peace. But today's his birthday, and I want to acknowledge that. And that was my weekend, people. That was it. So now let's get to my guest because I'm so excited. Please help me welcome makeup artist extraordinaire, beauty expert and author, Carmen D. Hello, Carmen D.
Well, hello, Teresa. How are you, beautiful?
I am so fabulous, Bella. I am, you know, you're with me tonight. So what could be better than that?
And I hear you're wearing my lipstick, which is even more fabulous.
I am commandized, and we're going to talk about that. But first, I want everyone to get to know you, because a lot of people know you from What Not to Wear, and now you're selling your makeup line on QVC. But you know, I want everyone really get to know you. You're a new California girl, right? You're originally from Newport Beach.
Born in Newport and raised in Huntington Beach, California, Surf City.
Yeah. Surf City. You went to Ocean View High School.
I sure did. Public high school. Yeah. Woo-hoo.
And then what happened and where did you go after high school?
Okay, how it all began. So growing up in Southern California, you know, you picture Baywatch, right? And pretty much that's kind of what everybody was running around looking like, but not me. I was the dumpy kid. I was, you know, overweight. I had permed hair. It was, you know, the 80s. My mom permed my hair. I had braces. And I was bullied like crazy and picked on. And I needed to find a way to kind of boost my self-esteem and feel good. So my mom was an artist, and she studied watercolor painting. And she used to take me to her watercolor classes, and I'd sit in the back and paint. And I just fell in love with it. And it was a way for me to express myself. And then I stumbled into makeup. And a friend of mine's dad was a makeup artist in Hollywood. And I said, wow, that's a job.
Yeah.
And so I was like, how about if I start, you know, playing with makeup on myself? It's a form of art that I was really into. And that's kind of what triggered it. I started using makeup as a way to feel empowered myself and confident. And then I was like, this is what I want to do. So I would look through, you know, magazines, and I didn't have a lot of friends in high school. I would go to the library and bring my fashion magazines and see these pictures of these, you know, women leaping on beautiful beaches and looking fabulous. And I said, I would say makeup buy. And I'm like, I want the job of doing makeup and traveling the world. So I talked to my friend's dad and I said, how do I get into this crazy business? And he goes, well, as soon as you're old enough to drive your little butt up to Hollywood and sign up for these at one of these agencies and become an apprentice. You work for free, you stay at home with your parents, and you just clean brushes, you're on set, and you learn. And that's what I did. And it went from there to moving to Miami. I've been now in New York 25 years. So I've been a makeup artist since 15 years old.
Wow. Well, at 18, you were working at the Merrill Norman Cosmetics.
That's right.
Was that your first official job, applying makeup to women?
That was my first job in makeup to pay for my gas money to drive up on the, you know, to do the gigs in Hollywood as an assistant. So right. That was enough money for that. And during that time, you know, I would meet a photographer's assistant on one of these jobs and we'd do a photo shoot together. And then I'd put one of those pictures in my portfolio and I just kind of started building from there. At 19, I was fired from Merle Norman for doing too many makeovers and not selling enough product. I was dragging women in to give them makeovers and I wasn't pushing the product. I just was having fun.
So you loved applying it, but you weren't pushy as a salesperson.
I wasn't a pushy salesperson. And then you're not going to believe this. Talk about divine intervention. The day I get fired, I'm so depressed and I'm going down the escalator, you know, with my car keys in my hand, just heartbroken. And there's a store downstairs with all these balloons around and it says grand opening. And it was called Clicks, which was one of the first glamour shots.
Yes.
Remember glamour shots?
Yes.
Right?
So I remember that.
I just marched right in and I said, well, I'm a makeup artist. And they hired me on the spot. So I had my gas money working at the glamour shots at the mall. And then I was driving to Hollywood being an apprentice and assisting. And that's kind of what put me on my way.
Wow.
The hustle.
Yeah, that's what happens. But, you know, you had an experience while you were working because a lot of women were basically complaining about their flaws.
That's right, all the time.
And I have to tell you the truth. Look, us as women, we beat ourselves up. We look at our flaws. I think our flaws is what jumps out at us first, if that makes any sense, where
yeah.
we should be looking at our attributes.
That's right.
And I also was bullied, picked on as a kid. I've had weight issues my entire life. I still struggle with my weight as of today. You know, I'm trying to get a hold on it, but it still has a hold on me. And I think that, you know, things that happen to you as a child when you're younger stays with you throughout your adulthood. And yep. You had a very traumatic experience, like myself, with someone who said something about your forehead.
Mm-hmm.
And it stayed with you. Do you want to tell everyone what happened with that?
Yeah, and you know, it's funny because you know that will segue onto why I got onto what not to wear, but during this time where my self-esteem was you know getting better and I was learning the art of makeup, I saved some money and I went to this you know cool hairdresser that everybody was going to in my town, and you know it was very expensive, and so I walked in and I thought you know, well, I know makeup and beauty, so we're going to get along fabulously, right? Hairdresser, makeup artist. And I walked in and he said, oh honey, your forehead is so huge and so big, you can shine a movie on it. He's like, you need to wear bangs for the rest of your life. And he chopped bangs on me. And I wore bangs pretty much from then, for years, because I was so insecure about it. And then as I got into this industry, and when I started using the philosophies I was teaching to women with myself, I realized that, oh my God, I need to be a voice for women everywhere, because this is what happened. Being a little girl that studied art with her mother, I learned how to see beauty in a different way. So I don't look at conventional beauty as being the be all end all. Mm-hmm. I see beauty in flaws in somebody who's different, who's somebody who's not conventionally beautiful, whether it's a large nose or a strange jawline or a quirky smile or a splattering of freckles or, you know, a scar, a crooked tooth. There's beauty in all of that, which comes from an artist's eye.
Right.
So that's what helped me become so self-confident and then be able to spread that word to all the women that I worked with.
Right. No, it's a very empowering thing that you do, because
yes.
we're going to get into what not to wear and how you got on it. But I just, every woman who sat in that chair, I had a tissue because I cried with them.
Yes.
And then, you know, it's so relatable because you kind of beat yourself up, which we know we shouldn't do. We should embrace our beauty. And, you know, the first thing you say is, what's the one thing you love about your face?
That's right. It's about retraining your brain. And that's why I loved being on What Not to Wear, is because it gave me an opportunity to start first on the inside, retrain the way a woman looks at herself in the mirror. Because if you play the compare and despair game, oh, I don't look like this, so I'm not good enough. So I'm going to use makeup.
I'll never look like Jennifer Aniston. Come on now.
I mean, yeah, it's like I'm not going to be an 18-year-old Brazilian model that I see in the magazines. It's not going to happen.
Not happening.
What happens is that women use makeup as a tool of insecurity. So they use makeup to chisel or contour or fix to look like somebody else's idea of beauty. And makeup goes back thousands of years ago, but it was actually used as a tool of empowerment when it originated. It was used for fertility. It was used for celebration, for rituals in a way that was more glorifying the woman, not, oh, I don't look like J-Lo, so right, I'm going to bronze the heck out of myself and try to look like that. It somehow it changed through the centuries, and we got to get back to using makeup as a tool of celebrating our uniqueness, celebrating ourselves, because guess what? We got one life on this planet. We go around once. So I don't want you being 90 years old looking back at yourself when you were 60, 40, 30, whatever your age is right now, and being, oh my God, I used to beat myself up over my fat thighs or my, you know, my hooded eyelids. It's like, we're lucky if we get to 90 and looking back.
It's hysterical because it's the truth, sister. Preach. You preach. Teaching to the choir. Oh yeah, I totally get it. I inherited my mother's hooded lids, and I try to embrace them. I do. And it's just something that, you know, like you said, everyone has something.
Everybody's got something, and I have worked with the most beautiful women in the world. I mean, I've worked with everybody from Cindy Crawford to, you know, you name the model, and they all have their own set of insecurities, every single one of them. And sure. and this is what I did learn on what not to wear from pretty much everyone. It stems from childhood. And I used to say to women, wait a minute, why do we care what a 10-year-old said to us on a playground or a 15-year-old ex-boyfriend said when we're grown women with children or a career, or, you know, we've accomplished all this greatness, but we still remember that stupid thing and we're still holding on to it?
It's true. Enough. Because what I heard my whole life was, you have such a pretty face. If you just lost the weight.
I mean, and now look where we are. We're body positive. Every size is beautiful.
That's
finally,
right.
Finally.
That's right. Yeah,
we're in ad campaigns. And the only thing left, I think, on the docket that we need to kick its butt is ageism, because that's still alive and kicking.
Oh,
and
yeah,
I've had it.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally hear you. Well, listen, I want to thank everyone for tuning in. Hi, Jennifer Lantini. Please like the show. Please share it. In the meantime, Carmen D is going to stay right there. You stay right there, everyone else. And we're going to take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back.
Fortunato's Pizza and Restaurant is located at 719 Hawkins Avenue in Ronkonkoma. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. You can find them on Facebook and Instagram. They do free deliveries to Ronkonkoma, Lake Grove, Center Reach, Nesconsent, Holbrook, and Selden. And they do catering for all occasions. Remember, mention Tea Time and get 10% off your entire order. So, Fortunato's Pizza. Move your pizza to Fortunato's a Pizza.
So where do you want to go tonight?
Are you bored?
Oh my God!
Hold on tight. We're going to Coasters.
Coasters Tavern is located at 487 Newbridge Road in East Meadow. Their number is 516-557-2222.
Well, hi there, Teresa. It's John York from General Hospital. I am just checking in because apparently you have a great talk show called Tea Time on Strong Island TV. I want you to have continued great success and have a lot of fun. It sounds like you're having a lot of fun. And that's pretty much the key to everything, isn't it? So continued success. I'm proud of you. Have a great day, Teresa. Bye.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Tea Time. I'm so glad you're joining me tonight, the 1st of February. Woohoo! And I want to thank Jennifer Lantini for watching, and a whole Bobby Inns is watching. And I'm here with Carmen D. Carmen D is a makeup artist. She's a beauty expert. She's an author. And we met a couple of years ago at a mutual friend's recording. And I was so happy to meet you. And I'm so thrilled. You know, because I've been a fan for so long, and now I'm a consumer. But Carmen D, you have been on Good Morning America. You've been on Fox News. You've been on in Elle magazine and in Style, and you've worked on a lot of famous people, including Cindy Crawford, like you mentioned before. But what a lot of people I know want to know, like myself, is how did you get on TV's Where?
It was a gift from God. I'll tell you that. I've been living in New York. I moved to New York in 1996. And I went from California to Miami to New York, working in fashion as a makeup artist for all the fashion magazines. And when I got to New York, it was just the beginning of reality TV. And I got tapped to be a spokesperson for Elle May. Oh. And so I was doing morning shows talking about spring trends. You know, spring trends, you know, for makeup. And then I would pitch the Elle May products. So I would do my photo shoots, and then I was doing these TV shows. Anyway, a fashion editor that I knew, Stacey London, came to me and said, you know, oh, they're casting this show called What Not to Wear, and they're looking for a makeup artist. And they couldn't find anybody that could speak on TV and knew beauty. And here I was already doing TV. So I went in and they hired me on the spot. And I'm like, great, what are we doing? I had no idea what the show was. I'm like, the first season was filmed in an apartment in Long Island City, and the hairdresser, Nick Arojo, would wash the hair in the bathtub, and I would sit Indian style on the floor and like talk to the woman, because we didn't know the show was going to go anywhere.
You know? 10 years, right? It was on for 10 years.
10 years. We are now a pop legend. You know, like it's like pop culture, because we were on for 10 years. It's still on the air. It's in 117 countries. And it was wonderful, because I was in fashion. I was always known as the light-handed makeup artist. I'd get the calls for the skincare campaigns or the photo shoots on the beach where the girls weren't wearing a lot of makeup. So I really knew how to do light-handed, quick, fast, easy. But I got onto What Not to Wear, and I was thinking to myself, all these women, they're not going to follow how to get a red carpet look. This woman has 6 kids, or this woman just went through a divorce, or this woman lost 100 pounds or starting a new job. They just need to know how to make themselves look and feel their very best. So at that moment, I told all the magazine editors, I will no longer talk about celebrities. I will only talk about real women. I want to be known as the real women's beauty guru, and I'm here for them, and that's the way it's going from now on. And at first, they weren't happy, because they wanted to hear all of the celebrity, you know, tips. And I was like, no, you'll get on board. And sure enough, they still interview me all the time, but I talk about how we all get the look that we're going for.
Right. Well, that's the whole thing, is, you know, you, and I think that's what, again, sets you, you know, separate from other makeup artists, is because, first of all, you want to know the insecurities so you can correct that.
That's right.
The first thing, because you say, then tell me the one thing you love about your face. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them sit there for a minute or two. That's kind of like when you go for an interview and they're like, you know, tell me about yourself. And you're like, you know, you don't talk about yourself too much, so you're not too sure what to say.
Right.
A lot of people do. They see the flaws, like we mentioned, right away. And then, you know, you say to them what your mother's mantra was, which mm-hmm. was, you are as beautiful as you are.
That's right.
And that hits home, because we all want to look our best. And you came up with the 5-minute face.
Yes, I did.
Because women have to get out the door. Okay. Mm-hmm. And it's a 5-minute face, and it's natural beauty.
That's right.
It's mm-hmm. bringing out and enhancing what we already have.
That's exactly right.
And that's because I've loved you, girl, for a long time. My whole thing was growing up, because you talk about your forehead. Mm-hmm. My whole thing, believe it or not, when I was younger, was my eyebrows.
Okay, you have great eyebrows.
Now I do, but because it took me freaking 56 years to figure out how to make them look natural. But what happened was is that my father has very thick, bushy eyebrows. And I inherited his look, because everyone says I look like my dad with my mother's nose. And my sister looks like my mother with my father's nose. Anyway, so I had these, you know, the unibrow. I had the unibrow going on. And at first, I would pluck the center. Mm-hmm, and then I'm like, oh, this is a pain in the butt. And then I would shave. I would take a razor and shave the center. And then my mother's like, don't pluck too much because
they won't grow back. That's right.
So, of course, I overplucked a little bit. Yeah. But that was my biggest thing, was my eyebrows. To me, I look back, you look back at pictures and you're like, oh, no, it was like a bad perm. It was just bad.
Well, but, and then in the 90s, we shaved them all off and penciled them in really small.
I know, exactly. So it's kind of like, you know, you're trying to stay up to date with the latest, you know, things that are going on with makeup. So, but later I'm going to ask you a few questions about makeup when we get into your makeup, because we're going to get into it. But, you know, the eyebrows were a big thing for me. And then I was told I had a very small forehead and I wouldn't be able to wear bangs. Isn't that funny?
There's no rules. And this is what's so crazy. There's no set standard of face shape or brow, forehead shape or nose shape or eye shape. That's all ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. Right. And there are no rules like that. So for somebody to say that you don't have a geometrically shaped face that's good enough, I want to slap him in the face. It's like that's because, I wrote 4 books about beauty.
And one of them was called Crazy.
Crazy, busy, beautiful.
Busy, beautiful. What were the other 3, by the way?
So the 5-minute face was the first one.
Right.
And that's your standard. It's still, you know, it's good today because it's your standard, you know, easy breezy.
Yeah.
Then the crazy, busy, beautiful is 600 tips on everything. Just tips. Yes. Like it's literally like tip of the days.
Right.
The third one, get positively beautiful, is about how to retrain your brain and start seeing yourself for the unique beauty you are and stop that negative commentary in your head. Mm. So I give you the tools you need. And then the last one is called Bloom, A Girl's Guide to Growing Up Gorgeous. And it's for tweens. And this is where falls into what you were just saying. So I explain in the book, and we all need to remember this, that women are like flowers, right? There's daffodils and roses and daisies and cactus flowers and, you know, frangipani, and there's a million flowers out there. And that's what creates a beautiful garden. They're all different. They're all unique. They're all beautiful. But yet we have this industry telling us everybody needs to look like the rose. So everybody's readjusting their faces, trying to look like a rose. Well, if the world's filled with roses, there's no beautiful garden anymore. It's the variety that makes everything beautiful. And we need to remember that.
It's a great analogy. It really is. Because I always feel, you know, they say beauty is in the eye of the beholder. And I feel the same way about you. I don't look at a person and judge them if they have something, an attribute that sticks out more than someone else.
Right.
I'm looking at them as a unique person.
That's right.
You know,
that's right.
That's how I feel about it. And I think
that
everyone should be that way. I mean, you know, like you said, a scar, a mole. I have moles on my face. I have moles. And I'm thinking, oh, should I get them removed? Should I not get them removed? And I have one here. My mother's like, oh, it's like a little beauty mark. And it's like, you know, it's just part of me.
It's who you are. Listen, I always said that I've been to a million fabulous parties with beautiful people. But, you know, the woman who walks in the room who might be in her 70s with like steel gray hair and she's got a prominent nose and she just walks in with confidence and she's not conventionally beautiful, but there's some air about her. She's the hottest woman in the room and everyone's looking at her going, who's that? So it really has everything to do with the way you carry yourself, your confidence, and owning who you truly are. Because when you try to look like someone else, or you're holding on to insecurities, or somebody compliments you and you're like, oh no, not me, you're dimming your light. And we have no time for that. Time goes so fast. Look what just happened this past year. My God, now when we do go back out in the world, we need to like lift our heads, celebrate who we are, and not give a damn what anyone thinks. That's what I try to tell the women on what not to wear. I had them revisit that childhood trauma or the ex-husband trauma, whatever trauma that made them insecure. We looked it in the face, we kissed it goodbye, and then I had them look in the mirror with a fresh new pair of eyes and say, now tell me what you love. And then all of a sudden they didn't look at the thing that they didn't like a hooded lid or, you know, a cheekbone that wasn't, you know, chiseled. They're like, oh, I have a really beautiful smile. I'm like, well, there's the feature focus.
I know. I'm a big fan of Nick too. And I know that there were a few times when Nick turned someone around and they weren't happy. My question is to you, was there anyone you ever turned around that wasn't in that moment?
Yeah. There was two that pop into mind. Probably the most famous is Denise, the flight attendant. Everybody remembers that episode. How could you
get her? Are you kidding me?
She was a flight attendant that looked like Minnie Mouse. And she talked in a really squeaky voice and wore 700 pounds of makeup.
And she didn't move her lips. She didn't move her lips. Like she was afraid she was going to crack her face or something.
She talked like this in a really high voice. And here's the sad thing and the truthful thing is when I was with her one-on-one and I took all the makeup off, and trust me when I say there was a pile of makeup remover wipes. Like so high. When her and I were alone and she had no makeup on, she got very dark and very sad and her voice changed. And I said, how do you feel? And she goes, I can't look at myself in the mirror. And I said, who did this to you? Because somebody had done this. This act, this mask, this costume was because something very traumatic had happened to her. And that was one episode where I did take the producers aside and I said, this isn't Dr. Phil. This is dangerous to go too deep with this girl. I feel for her. I'm going to give her a lot of makeup, more makeup than usually my Carmen Dyes look, but we can't dive very deep here. This is not okay. And so I did as much more makeup than I normally do and turned her around, and she didn't feel comfortable without the costume because
she looked beautiful.
She looked amazing.
Girl.
You can Google it. Like,
do you believe less is more?
I absolutely believe less is more. I always have. I've always been the lighter approach makeup artist. I don't believe in contour. I think contour is a form of shame. Because it's saying, here's why I always Carmen Dyes, you know, Carmen Dyesing from the show, and it's in my line.
I'm Carmen Dyes tonight.
Girl, and I'm telling you, the reason why is because what is highlight on the face? It's light. Well, what is light? Light is energy. So you are bouncing energy from the own planes of your face, which is bringing that attraction to you. That's bringing that energy back to you. Right. When you contour, that's a heavy, opaque powder that you're making disappear parts of you that are there. That's not going to get you noticed. Highlighting.
That was my questions. We're going to take another quick break. When we come back, we're going to play yay or nay.
Okay.
And that's what we're going to find out about some makeup things. So I want to thank everyone for watching. Hello, Hottie Toddy and Nancy and Grace Budotti in the Boogie Down Bronx. Please like the show. Please share it. Don't go away. We'll be back with Carmen D.
Yay.
So where do you want to go tonight?
Why don't we go to Coasters?
Oh, cool. I heard it's a great place. Let's check it out.
Yeah, definitely.
All right.
Oh my God. Coasters Tavern is located at 487 New Bridge Road in East Meadow. The number's 516-557-2222.
Fortunato's Pizza and Restaurant is located at 719 Hawkins Avenue in Ronkonkoma. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. You can find them on Facebook and Instagram. They do free deliveries to Ronkonkoma, Lake Grove, Center Reach, Nesconsent, Holbrook, and Selden, and they do catering for all occasions. A, remember, mention tea time and get 10% off your entire order. So, Fortunato's Pizza. Move your pizza to Fortunato's a Pizza.
How you doing? It's Sal, the voice of Valentinetti. Why are you watching me? You should be watching Teresa Canastracy Tea Time with Teresa Canastracy Farrell. And make sure you follow Teresa on Facebook, Tea Time with Teresa Canastracy Farrell. We'll see you there.
I love the way you say my name. I love it.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Tea Time. I'm so glad you're joining me tonight. I want to thank Fortunato's Pizzeria for being my sponsor. They're located on Long Island, and if you mention Tea Time, you get 10% off your order. So that's really cool. Their food is amazing, and I love their slogan, Move your pizza to Fortunato's a Pizza. So give them a call and check them out. Really, their food is amazing. I also want to thank John York from the last commercial break from General Hospital for saying such lovely things about Tea Time. I had Carolyn Hennessy on the show from General Hospital. I'm hoping to get more people from the show to come on in 2021. You never know. And I want to thank Sal the Voice Valentinetti, who's in nice, warm, sunny Florida right now, for his plug on Tea Time. And I think that's it. I want to thank everyone for watching, and please like the show, please share it. I'm so glad you're joining me tonight on this cold, blustery winter night, because I'm here with Carmen D, who is a makeup artist, and she's a beauty expert, she's an author, and she was on TLC's What Not to Wear for 10 years, and that's how we all, you know, found her and loved her, and then we watched her on Good Morning America and Fox News and Elle and in Style and, you know, and just really making you feel comfortable with yourself and your flaws and learning how to love yourself.
That's
and
right.
what God gave you. You know, that's the bottom line. So I'm so glad Carmen D is here tonight.
I'm here.
So you want to talk about the 5-minute face?
I do. I'm so excited to explain it.
Yeah.
So listen. I created the 5-minute face when I was on What Not to Wear, because there were so many women that are like, I hate makeup, or I don't have time to do makeup, or I have anxiety over makeup. And anyone watching this, how many times have you walked into a Sephora or a drugstore or a department store and you look at the makeup section and you get anxiety? You don't even know where to begin. There's 1,600 shades of lipsticks. There's 5,000 eyeshadows. And you're afraid to ask the person working there because you don't want to look like them, because they're wearing even more.
Right.
So because I've been a makeup artist for 30 years, I know shades that work on every skin tone. I know products and textures that work on every skin tone. So on What Not to Wear, I didn't have my makeup line yet, but what I did is I was doing research for the book, and I read case studies by scientists about beauty. And it said, when is a woman at her most beautiful? And the scientific studies said, well, they looked through centuries and beauty standards changed. Different tribes in different parts of the world, different, you know, years, different, you know, going back to caveman days, there wasn't a thread where a woman was always beautiful, except no matter where she was, what time in the world she was in, a woman's always her most beautiful when she's her most fertile. No matter what she looks like. So that broke down to 5 things. Number 1, her skin glows. So I created my Carmenizing highlighting technique. Number 2, her eyes capture attention because she's trying to get her suitor. So that's eyeliner and flirty lash mascara.
Right.
You know, her cheeks flush on a cellular level because she's blushing. So I created At First Blush. And then her lips get engorged with a little bit of blood because she wants to make out. So that's how I created all 5 pieces for the 5-minute face. So I started doing that on every woman, whether she was 70 or 17. And those steps and those products would bring that woman to her most beautiful natural self. So I was like, now I have to have a line because I have to make this product for everyone. And that's how Carmody Beauty came to be. I created first and foremost the 5-minute face.
And Carmen de Beauty was launched on QVC September 2019.
Yep.
Right? And yeah. You've been there ever since. And I was thrilled to see you on QVC, girl, because my whole thing was I always had, you know, back in the 80s, we plowed, like you said, we plowed it on, and I had the problem with my eyebrows, and, you know, and then they were saying, oh, you have blue eyes, so you should wear brown because it brings out the blue. And I'm like, you know, all these things that you hear throughout your life. And I remember when I was working in the city, there was a makeup company that was there. I'm not going to say which one. And they said, oh, come in, come in. We'd like to do a free makeover.
Yeah. They hooked you. Okay.
So I walk in and they put everything on me that was either blush or coral. Everything. I mean, everything. I look like a peach. From here up, I look like a peach. But I'm thinking, wow, it's so different. Yeah, it's so nice. Then I bought the product and I used it maybe a couple more times. And I'm like, I don't feel myself.
Even
this on. Do you know what I mean?
Exactly. Exactly.
So you came to QVC and I want to buy everything you have, but I have to do it in little drips and drabs.
The price is amazing.
The first thing I bought, which I have to let everyone know, the first purchase I made, because I'm a lipstick girl, and my grandmother always said, you never go out with something on your, never go out without anything on your lips.
Yep. Yes.
And my, I remember her sitting there in the dining room and always putting on her lipstick, always putting on a lipstick. She had to have lipstick on. And then of course, when she was done with the lipstick, she'd go, okay.
Yep.
So I purchased your trio of your berry trio.
The berry trio.
So there's passion berry, which I'm wearing tonight.
Beautiful. One of my favorite colors ever.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I'm wearing passion berry, and you get cocoa berry, and you get spiced berry. Mm-hmm. And I have to say, love
Aren't they the best?
I love them. Okay. And then I purchased, because I'm going to let everyone know what I'm wearing tonight. I wanted a new blush, and I purchased your blush, which is the At
Love Struck
blush. Mm-hmm. And yes, Love Struck. That's what I bought. So this is
what I'm wearing too.
Love Struck. This is what I bought. And I have to tell you, you have to, like you said, less is more. Because when I first applied it, I'm like, whoa, give me the tissue. And I took some tissue.
You barely go like this.
Yes. You don't need a lot of it. You just don't. So, okay. So I have the Love Struck. Okay. Love Struck Pour. So I'm telling everyone I'm wearing. And then, hello, what's a Carmody face without getting Carmodized?
You gotta get
so
Carmodized.
I got the Carmodizing highlighter in rose gold.
Yeah, that's good for you.
And, okay, and I have the brushes. Now, this is the brush for the blush. And this is the fan brush. This is the fan brush on one side. Okay, I'm going to show you how to use that in a minute. And then you have the little, okay, and what I did was I took it, and tell me if I'm doing it right, but I did the corner of my eyes, the corner of my eyes.
That's right.
I commandize, you sweep, when you sweep on the above the cheekbone, right?
Yep.
And then I wanted just a little something more. I put it a little, just above the
three key places.
Brows, that's it. And then I put a little dish at the bottom.
That's right. So did I. Dish. Oh my God, you are such a good student. I love it.
Listen to me. If you ever need somebody as a model, let me know. I'll go to QVC with you, girl.
I mean, mask up. Right now we're doing it all virtual from home. I have a QVC show at 7 a.m. tomorrow selling my three favorite most like hit products, the most sold out ever. They just came back in stock, my Got You mascara. So these are on sale tomorrow. You get a 9-month supply.
Okay, so I'm ordering them. What time? 7 a.m.?
7 a.m. is when the beauty shows.
People, tune in tomorrow to comment on QVC. Okay, so you sold out mascara. Yeah. And what else? Yeah. What else did you have that sold out?
Oh my gosh, everything sells out. It's so crazy. So I mean, I went to QVC and I said, listen, you guys, you have all these like either celebrity brands or brands started by other people. Why don't you have a brand just for QVC that's made by a woman who's done beauty for 30 years? I know how to make products. I know the right shades. I know what women want because I'm listening to women because I'm working with real women and listening to what they can't find. And, you know, and there's anxiety over choosing things. I know how to streamline it, make colors that work for everyone. So we partnered and it's been an amazing success.
Oh, I'm so happy for you. I'm so thrilled for you. I really am. I'm glad that you found a home there.
I wanted to continue teaching. I didn't want to be another product on the shelf. I wanted to explain to you why it works, why that the lipstick you're wearing you love. Long wearing lipstick dries out your lips, gets crusty, causes flaking, it builds up in the corners. You need a hydrating lipstick that has rich, juicy color. So that's why I made the hydrating lipsticks. When it comes to highlighter.
And I want everyone to know the one you're wearing.
Perfect Rose.
Is Perfect Rose. So if everyone likes that, go to QVC and get Perfect Rose.
Perfect Rose.
I love it.
So let me tell you a little bit about the blush story. This is such a great story.
Yes.
So when I was trying to create the universal shade of blush that would work on every woman, and it's the only blush color I carry in my kit, whether you have the darkest of complexion or the lightest of complexion, I actually went to the Met in New York and I kind of started studying Renaissance paintings. And I got home and I'd pour through books and I was looking at all these, you know, painters, these, from Vermeer to you name it. And all these portrait paintings, and there was this cheek color that they all had that I was like, what is that perfect natural flush in these grand artists' paintings? So I took it to a friend of mine who was studying painting at the time, and she said, this is the color. I said, no way. That's why when you probably got the blush home, you're like, this color is the one she's selling?
I opened it up, and I was like, I don't know about this.
It works on everyone, every skin tone. You can go to QVC.com or CarmenDBeauty.com and you can see every skin tone. You can wear this color. It's the one and only blush shade I carry because it mimics that natural flush in the most easy way. So what I just streamline your life, take an anxiety away. You don't have to choose. Easy.
It's great. Listen, we're going to take our last quick commercial break. When we come back, we're going to play nay or yay. Basically, I'm going to ask comedy questions, beauty questions, things you should or shouldn't do. So girls, men, whoever's watching, don't go away because we're going to be right back with Carmen D.
Fortunato's Pizza and Restaurant is located at 719 Hawkins Avenue in Ronkonkoma. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. You can find them on Facebook and Instagram. They do free deliveries to Ronkonkoma, Lake Grove, Center Reach, Nesconsent, Holbrook, and Selden. And they do catering for all occasions. Remember, mention Tea Time and get 10% off your entire order. So, Fortunato's Pizza. Move your pizza to Fortunato's a Pizza.
So where do you want to go tonight?
Are you bored?
Oh, oh my god!
Hold on tight. We're gonna coast this.
Coasters Tavern is located at 487 New Bridge Road in East Meadow. Their number is 516-557-2222.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Tea Time. I'm so glad you're joining me tonight. Thank you, Christine, for joining in, and Grace, and again, Hottie Toddy, and Jen, and Bobby Inns. When you get a chance, please like the show. Please share it. I'm with a friend who I met a couple of years ago through another mutual friend, Carmen D, and we all know her and love her from What Not to Wear, and now she's selling beautiful, beautiful, beautiful cosmetics on QVC, and she's going to be on actually tomorrow morning at 7 a.m., and she has her wonderful Carmen D highlighter that I have, and I have her blush, and I have her beautiful lipstick. And I know I need a lot more. And she's coming. She has a fragrance, a beautiful fragrance for what? What'd you say, $19?
It's $19.
Hello, $19 called Wanderlove.
Wanderlove.
Oh, girl. So we're not only going to look good, we're going to smell good, but I can't wait to watch QVC tomorrow morning. But listen, we're going to play something called Yay or Nay. So
fine.
I'm going to ask you some beauty questions and,
yeah,
you know, you can answer, you know, any way you want. Okay. When you mentioned before, and for those who maybe just joined us, bronzer.
Yay.
Okay.
But not used as a contour, used as a bronzer.
Okay. So it's an all over bronzer look, not just your.
No, it's a, I have a great one in my line that's very sheer like a watercolor.
Okay. Writing that one down too. Okay. Colored mascara other than brown or black?
Nay. Nay.
Okay.
Unless you're 18.
Did you hear that, ladies? Don't be putting no purple mascara on.
Please don't.
Or green or blue.
Crazy.
Okay. Eyeliner, when it comes to the inner lid.
Yay.
Say, ooh, it makes your eyes look bigger.
Or sexier,
I guess, for like a smoky eye.
I say yay, because listen, there's no set standard of eyes. You can have small eyes, big eyes. If you like to rock that little sexy eyeliner look, go for it.
What about the white that they're putting on the inside?
As long, I like, there's a liner that's not white. It's more flesh toned. If you want a wider wig look, you could do that. But the white is if you're going out at night or to like an event and you want to create a look, but it's too garish for daytime.
Okay. So did you hear that, ladies? White at night. Okay. Got that. Okay, lip liner. Do we need lip liner?
So that would be a nay for colored lip liners and a yay for neutral lip liner. So if it matches your lipstick perfectly in a neutral tone, fine, but you don't want ring around the mouth.
Okay, neutral. Well, because back in the day, like in 1988, my friends used to take a very berry color lip liner, and she'd outline lips and then put a very light color on the inside of the lips.
I would do Wet n Wild raspberry lip liner with snow cone pink Revlon lipstick on the inside and then crimp my hair. Mom is almost 50, so I remember I used to do it, and I'm a professional.
Okay, so let me ask you a question, because we talked about my hooded lids before. What tips would you give someone like me who has a hooded lid? Because sometimes I have a hard time with shadows. To be honest with you, I don't have any shadow on. I just have an eyeliner.
That's beautiful. Well, see, this is the thing is that, again, like earlier we were talking about feature focus, play up your best features. You look amazing with gorgeous eyeliner and you're highlighted and your mascara is on. So you don't even need eyeshadow. But if you do, you can wear eyeshadow with hooded lids. What you want to do is make sure that you take the color where your lid used to be or, you know, once was. Just tap on the back of your eyeball, and where you feel that area is where you bring your shadow up to.
Okay.
So if you have hooded lids and you're like, well, I don't have that crease, you sure do. It's there. You just tap and there it is. So bring that shadow up to that point, and that will make the shadow appear so it looks nice.
That's great. I love that advice. What else did I want to ask you? We have 5 minutes left. This is so fair. Okay, so let's talk about a big birthday. You have a big birthday coming up on March 26th.
Yes.
You're going to be the big 50.
I'm going to be 50.
Girl, you wear
like
it well.
I'm 15.
You wear it well. I was there actually 6 years ago. And it's fun. It's a fun birthday. And I have to say, 50s. You're so mature in your 50s, and you don't really, like you said, you don't want to waste any time.
No.
You know what I mean? No. You're only here once, and it goes fast. So
you trim out the people you don't need. You want shiny, happy people around. And any chance you get to dance, do it.
That's good advice. I like that a lot. So who inspired you? I know your mom was an artist.
Yeah.
But there was there anyone that that inspired you to,
well, yes,
you know, pursue this dream of yours?
Yeah, I mean, first and foremost, I would say it was Kevin Aucoin was the very first makeup artist to come out and make the job itself kind of a fabulous, you know, job. Like he came out with the book Yeah. I realized, oh, that's actual career, this makeup artist for fashion. And then Bobbi Brown was a superhero because she came out with, she was a makeup artist that created a beauty line, you know, yes, back in the 80s. So it was the 80s, 90s, yeah, 90s, 80s, around that time. And so I kind of molded myself after her when I got into the beauty space, because I am for real women, just like she was back then. And my approach is a little bit more lighter handed and fun, and even down to my packaging. I want you to feel good when you look at the package.
The packaging's wonderful. And isn't, you know, it? What's amazing about your line, and I want everyone to tune into QVC tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. Okay. Yeah. I have the At First Blush in the Love Struck Rose, amazing for everyone. I have the Commandizing highlighter, which is beautiful. It just brings so light pretty to your face. Okay, I have the three lipsticks. This is the Berry family. And of course, I've got these beautiful, beautiful, beautiful brushes.
So pretty.
I want everyone, oh, here's a good question. How often should we wash our brushes?
Every week.
Weekly.
And weekly. We're so lazy. And
we are.
I'm going to tell you what to do. You just order it right now when you're done watching this. It's called Cinema Secrets Brush Cleaner. You can get it at Sephora. You can get it on Amazon. It's one of those dip, wipe, and instantly dries. So there's no excuses. So there's no washing with baby shampoo and drying out. You dip, wipe it off, dries instantly, and then your brushes kind of smell like vanilla. So it's easy to use.
What's it called again?
Cinema Secrets Brush Cleaner.
Secrets.
Yes.
Okay. Everyone get
it's, that. Because, it was started by.
We don't listen. No one people don't wash their brushes on a weekly basis. But if you get something like this that you just dip and dry, I mean, that's like a.
There's no excuse. You got to get rid of the bacteria, and this way the color will go on smoothly, and also it won't, you know, clog your pores and everything else, which dirty brushes can do.
What's the one thing women do that they should not do?
Choose the wrong foundation and wear too much. You need to go lighter. As we get older, lighter. My foundation, my hydrating foundation is waterproof. You can wear it as thin as a tint up to medium coverage. I have a full face of it on right now, but it makes your skin look like skin. You don't have that thick, crusty, cakey. It doesn't settle into fine lines. I see so many women, as they get older, think they have to erase their face with powdered foundations.
Right.
And that is the worst thing you can do as we age. It makes you look older, it makes you look thicker, and it looks dry. So
tomorrow I'm going to be buying, tomorrow morning I'll be buying foundation, I'll be buying the bronzer, right?
You'll be fair in foundation.
I will.
Your bronzer's going to be golden sand.
So my bronzer is going to be golden sand. Look, she knows this just by looking at me.
Yeah.
Golden sand and the
foundation is fair.
Fair. Really? I thought it was a medium.
I'm seeing fair on you.
Well, I got the ring light on too, so it's like.
Ugh. Yeah. Yeah. I'll take another. I know, because ring lights, it's like.
Ring lights are just, you know. But listen, we have like a minute. I want everyone to follow you. Okay, now Carmen D Beauty. You could go to CarmenDBeauty.com. She's Carmen D Beauty on Twitter,
on Instagram.
She's all over the place. Follow her. Watch her videos. And also real quick, you made videos. Made videos called In Her H-E-R in brackets, In Her Beauty. And I watched some of them, and everyone has to watch them too. So go online and watch those as well. Carmen D, you could come back anytime you want. Girl.
I love you so much. You are so much fun. You are so beautiful, and I love the show.
Thank you so much. So real quick before we go, tomorrow morning, 7 a.m. QVC, CarmenDBeautyEverything.com, Instagram, and Twitter. I don't tweet, but I'm on Instagram. But I want to, again, thank you so much for taking the time. You're going to stay right there. I'm going to say goodbye to everybody else. Thank you, everyone, for watching tonight. Please like the show. Please share it. And come join me next week, because I have on a legend next week. And I want everyone to join me. The month of February is going to be crazy with my guests. And all I'm going to promise is that they're just going to get bigger and better for 2021. Carmen D, stay where you are. Everyone tune in to QVC tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. See everyone next week. Stay safe. Stay warm. Wear a mask. Ciao, everybody.